start with a KCCI News exclusive.
With just 2 days to go now before America may no longer be able to pay its bills, our own Kevin Cooney just wrapped up a face-to-face interview with the president on the chances of a deal before the deadline. Kevin joins us now live from the White House with his exclusive story. Kevin?
Well, Elizabeth and Eric, it's kind of strange how the feeling has shifted here in the past few hours. It's really pretty glum right now, not necessarily at the White House, but over the other end of Pennsylvania Avenue, down by the Capitol. You know, earlier there was this report of a Senate compromise that was coming forth this morning. There was lots of optimism, but things turned a very much pessimistic way by the time this evening approached. There was a House bill that was DOA that we told you at 5 when it was first put forth this morning, and now some compromise. But we understand just within the past few moments, the Associated Press is reporting that a vote on this second House deal has now been postponed. It's a state of confusion, as one fellow reporter said just a few moments ago. So it begs the question, as we question the president today, is this a philosophy of my way or the highway?
I think that's a mistake to analyze it that way. The Democrats agreed during this period of longer budget negotiations to accept the Republican budget, which is far lower than what the Democrats want. But in the interest of keeping the government open, Democrats in Congress, as well as me here in the White House, said, fine, we'll actually take your number. What happened then was that in addition to us taking their number, they then said, let's repeal Obamacare. That's how this whole thing happened. The truth is that we haven't asked for anything to keep the government open. What I've said is we'll just maintain current law. But let's not inflict pain on the American people while we're trying to work out our differences.
So if there is a short-term budget deal that allows for a longer-term budget,
everything's on the table. We can talk about anything you want, and there are a lot of Republican ideas that I may find attractive.
Are there elements of the Affordable Care Act that are on the table or will be on the table?
You know, what I've said is...
Any element at all?
Absolutely. What I've said is that any specific suggestion that Republicans have that improves how we can make sure health care is affordable to all Americans, people with pre-existing conditions, people who right now are priced out of the market, I'm happy to look at. And I don't think there's any piece of legislation that's perfect. And so if they want to sit down and talk to me and they say, look, here are some specific things that we think would really make this work better, then I'd be happy to consider it.
We'll have much more on the Affordable Care Act tonight on the news at 10. You know how it's gotten off to kind of a rough start, Elizabeth and Eric, when it comes to the sign-up procedures that have, well, jammed up computers all across the country. We talked to the president as to whether that may be indicative as to what will happen when when the program itself is fully implemented.
And Kevin, it sounds like things have really been changing by the minute at this point. Can you talk a little bit more about the mood, and do people really seem to think that a compromise can be reached on all of this at this point?
Well, as you heard in Major Garrett's report, the president on CBS, the president was talking about how optimistic he was that something could happen. But as we mentioned, from the other end of the street, so to speak, we're getting a really glum feeling and a questionable feeling as to whether the government will be able to come up with some sort of a budget compromise, but perhaps more important, within the next 36 hours, come up with something that's going to raise the debt ceiling.
All right. Kevin Cooney, live in Washington. Thanks so much.